Let's look into a few of the Minikube commands that are very useful and are going to get you, you know, even more familiar with the particular system. So one of these commands is we can use to output the environment variable like dockerenv. So we can say Minikube dockerenv. So if you have worked with Docker machines, you'll notice that the output is sort of similar. And you can see both the Docker machine env and Minikube Docker env serve the same purpose. Cool. So basically, they just output the environment variables that are required for a local Docker client to communicate with a remote server of Docker. And in this particular case, that Docker server is inside a virtual machine that is being created by a Minikube. Cool. All right. You can also do some verification, for example, list all the running containers on that virtual machine. So you can do docker container ls. So you can see Minikube is running over here. Let me just zoom out a little bit. So you can see it's running over here. And these are basically all the containers that are required by Kubernetes. So we can say that these are like, we can consider them as like system containers. But that's a little bit more for you to explore. All right. Also, since almost everything in that virtual machine is a container pointing to the local Docker client that we have, so it should be, you know, basically all you need besides kubectl. Still, in some cases, you might want to SSH into the virtual machine. So you can say, I can also, you know, Minikube SSH, for example. I can say docker container ls. Tada. So we basically entered into the Minikube, listed all the containers, and now we can also exit out of it like that. Cool. We can also confirm something else. We can maybe check if kubectl is also pointing to that particular virtual machine of Minikube. So in order to do that, we can say kubectl config current context Minikube. So it's basically saying that kubectl is configured to talk to the Kubernetes inside the newly created cluster. We can also list all the nodes from kubectl. We can say kubectl get nodes. It's also saying Minikube, and there we go. Now notice something, that it only says that there is one node, because we mentioned in the beginning that it works as the master node as well as the worker node. That is why we have over here. Let's look at all the components that are currently running in our cluster. Notice that this is a very tiny cluster and don't have much things going on over here. So I can say kubectl get all namespaces. Missed a flag over here. There we go. So you can see I have a few things running because I already used it before, and you have the Kubernetes dashboard and all these other things that are running. So you'll learn more about like deployments and all these other things in the future sessions. And some of the common Minikube commands are something that we can look into. So for example, you can look into stopping Minikube. So if I just do Minikube stop, so it will stop your Kubernetes cluster. So it will basically shut down the virtual machine, but it is going to preserve all the cluster state and data. So starting the cluster again, it's going to restore it to the previous state. So you can start it again using Minikube start, or you can also delete it using Minikube delete. So if I just do Minikube delete, so this can be used to delete the cluster. It's gonna shut down and delete the Minikube virtual machine. One thing to note over here is that no data or state will be preserved.